Is this LJ McCray?
Yeah, this is LJ McCray.
Sorry for the mix-up.
Oh, it's alright.
Thanks again for doing this interview and taking a little time out of your day.
Oh, no problem, no problem at all.
Okay, first question. How did you fall in love with the game of football?
It all started when I was about 7 years old. Basically, I was already playing every sport, and my mother decided, like, that I told her that baseball was too boring for me, actually, and then she was like, okay, well, we'll try football, and it just so happened that, you know, I was good at it, and I liked it, everything about it. I could play every sport, I mean, every position, and, you know, I was fast. I liked contact, so it was just like something that stuck with me, and I've just been in love with it ever since.
Which NFL player did you look up to growing up, and who would you say you modeled your game after now?
Okay, well, growing up, it was always me, Sean Taylor, Devin Hester, and those were like my players, the main players I looked at. Then it became Ray Lewis and Brian Dawkins. But I would say I modeled my game after Brian Dawkins. He's a powerful leader, you know, was when he played, and he still is to this day. And he knew the game, he knew everything about it, every position. And he made the plays, you know, that he was supposed to make that made him a great legend. So that's why I'm on my game now.
What are your strengths and weaknesses as a player?
My strengths, I'm very physical, athletic. I can run. I can pretty much do it all, like playing the box, and also, you know, guard receivers outside and one on one. But my weaknesses are sometimes bad angles. And I know the game, you know, just sometimes I don't slow it down, and I try to play it too fast, and I mess up on angles. So I would say my angles are my weaknesses, and that's pretty much my weakness.
Were you recruited much out of high school, and why did you choose Catawba?
Yes, I was recruited out of high school. Had a few schools that I talked to. Mainly it was because of my grades. I didn't do what I needed to do in the classroom at the time. I was young, making mistakes. So, you know, it was a lot harder for schools to take a chance on me with them knowing that, you know, I might not be there for my entire career, you know. That was one thing that I messed up with. So I ended up choosing Catawba last minute because they actually stuck with me and about the entire recruiting process. And they were there, you know, when all the other schools dropped off and weren't recruiting me, they were there. And so I chose Catawba, and it ended up being, you know, a great choice for my career.
What were you trying to prove to scouts at your pro day?
I was trying to prove to scouts that I can run. A lot of scouts question my speed. I don't know why, I guess, because, I never really had a chance to, like, open up, I guess, about my speed, you know, and me coming from a Division II school, you know. They were saying that, you know, I'm pretty much faster than everybody there, but what about, can I play with D1? With D1 guys and NFL guys, and I'm just proving that it doesn't matter where you come from, you know, everybody can play, you know, and I feel like I was out there to prove to them that I can play at the next level, no matter what, you know, no matter what you may put against me, but I can play at the next level. So that was my main thing to prove at my pro day.
How did the team meetings go?
Excuse me?
How did the team meetings go?
Oh, the team meetings went well. It was pretty good. I talked to a few teams, and you know, they basically told me what they like and what I need to work on. So mainly right now in this whole process and getting ready for the draft, I've been working on what teams told me I need to work on and focus on being able to get my body right to play for a long time at the next level.
What was the most memorable moment of your college career?
Career. I would have to say my sophomore year, when I returned two kickoffs in one game for touchdowns and broke the school record and broke the NCAA record and won All-American that year. It was a great experience for me, and that was definitely one of the highlight moments.
Who was the best player you faced in college?
Best player out of college, I would have to say Bo Cardell, the quarterback from Tuscaloosa College. He was definitely one of the best guys I faced since I've been here. because he was here for every year that I was. He registered the year just like I did, you know. And he actually put up a challenge against him every year to try to stop this passing game. And although he had like great receivers, he was a very smart quarterback. So it took us a while, you know. We had to like figure him out, but he definitely gave him those challenges. So I would say that's definitely one of the best players I've ever played.
Why should an NFL team take a chance on you?
They can take a chance on me because I'm willing to do anything. I'm willing to come in and be a special team guy. I'm willing to learn. I'm smart enough to pick up on defense pretty fast. And I know I have what it takes to make a long career out of it. I don't want to just be there for 1 year or 2 years. I want to actually build a career and be there as long as I can. And because I know I give my all to the team and for these coaches and players, I give my all. I don't have attitude. I don't get into the play. I'm a great teammate. You know, it's always team first with me. I'm never a selfish guy. So that, I would say teams should take a chance on me because I'm going to be there. I'm going to do what it takes.
Okay, one more question. It's kind of off the football type question, but favorite music artist and hobby outside of football?
That's tough. I don't really have a favorite artist because I listen to a lot of music. That's really tough. I don't have a favorite artist. I listen to everything, every genre, every type of music. So I can't say I have a favorite artist. Right now, the guy that I listen to a lot right now, I have to say, is August Alsina. But as far as a hobby, really just working out and playing the game. I like to tell my boys, man. We sit back, we talk about football. You know, you learn without knowing that you learn. You know, when you're talking to people about the sport that you love. So we sit around, we talk about football, we play the game. You know, we just I just like to just chill, just relax, and definitely chill with my dog. I love my dog, so. That would be a hobby.
Okay. Thanks again for the interview, and good luck to you in the future.
Okay, thank you.